It's the Christian Road Warrior. That's right. And I'm in your face, Trenholmes. That's right. I'm back for you, Trenholmes. Now, do you know why? You tried to deconstruct Monica D, my sister in Christ, and I don't like that. So I'm gonna do the chivalrous thing. Hey, chivalrous, that's a big word for the warrior. I'm gonna do the chivalrous thing and defend her honor. Cut the music! Now, in your process of alleged deconstruction, you made a fatal flaw, or should I say fallacy. It's called misinterpreting the Bible. Ever heard of a thing called hermeneutics? Well, if you didn't, it's a 50-cent word for just reading the Bible correctly and interpreting it correctly according to established principles. One of those principles is you use scripture to interpret scripture. You don't just willy-nilly make up stuff off the top of your head, as you obviously did here. I'm going to play the clip.
Here Dennington quotes Revelations 12, verse 11. And really you should read verses 1 through 12 to get the full meaning. But verse 11, the one that she focuses on, says, "They overcame him," that is the devil, "by the blood of the Lamb," which is the sacrifice of Jesus.
Good so far.
"And by the word of their testimony," that is to say, Christians' individual stories of how they came to understand Christ.
Correct again.
"They did not love their lives so much as to shrink from death." This verse says that you should not love life so much that if necessary, you will kill anyone that Christ considers the devil. Basically, everyone not Christian. Therefore, a real Christian should be ready to kill everyone.
What the heck? Where the heck did you get that? That's so crazy, it's laughable! Thank you! No clapping. Just laugh. Anyway, that's stupid! I'm gonna call it what it is. I'm not calling you stupid. I'm calling the stupid interpretation by you stupid. You know, it's not hard to pick up a Bible commentary. You can get them free on the internet. BlueLetterBible.com. Now I'm going to read to you from the Matthew Henry Bible Commentary. Here it is. BlueLetterBible.com, which explains what that part of the passage means. "They love not their lives unto the death, when the love of life stood in competition with their loyalty to Christ. They loved not their lives so well, but they could give them up to death, could lay them down in Christ's cause. Their love to their own lives was overcome by stronger affections of another nature." Close quote. Now, what does that mean, Trenholmes? I'll tell you what it means. It means that you deserve a special award for misinterpreting the Bible in such a way that I've never, ever seen in about 15 years of studying atheistic, agnostic, unbelieving literature. I've never seen an interpretation that wild and out in way on left field, outer space, in a black hole somewhere. Ridiculous. Why don't you read Matthew 10:37-39, Luke 14:26-27, and see that it's talking about believers sacrificing themselves, their lives, for the faith, not killing people. That's stupid! And I'm out of here, and I'll be back to deconstruct your other stuff. And there's nothing you can do about it because I'm the warrior.